to be done, cleaning and cooking. But if it's a burden, it's a joyful one. Spring is here, family and friends gather, and every serious cook is convinced that only she really knows how to make the traditional food served at a proper Seder. And what is a Seder without a knedel? A dumpling? A matzo ball. I like mine dense and chewy.
I love mine large and fluffy as clouds.
No. The hard ones. That's what my mother made.
Don't tell me how to make matzo balls. Look, I'll show you. Now we're coming to the educational part of this evening. Up to now was entertainment. Well, the matzo ball was created 40 years after the Jewish people, or the Israelites, left Egypt. All the 40 years in the desert, they didn't have to cook. Everything was prepared. Used to get up in the morning and they found manna white and fluffy, didn't cost them a penny. And the women forgot how to cook. That was a wonderful thing. After 40 years, they had to make a seder and didn't know what to do. What do you cook? How do you make? But there's one Jewish woman there. I know she was Jewish. Who else was going to think about her matzo ball? Of course she was Jewish. Okay. Now, I'm going to take 4 eggs. Everything is pre-measured. And I put it in here. And you don't have to beat it. It's not a cake. You have to just mix it up a little. And you take salt, either to your taste or to your high blood pressure. And you mix it up a little there. You don't have to make a big seamless out of it. I take a half a cup, instead of water, I put chicken soup. And I mix it up, and now I have a problem. The thing that you're not supposed to, I call it schmaltz or chicken fat. And, well, schmaltz is not exactly a food, schmaltz is a way of living. But because we're not supposed to have any more schmaltz, so I'm going to have a substitute, and that is oil. You mix it in, 1/3 cup oil. You don't have to mark it down. I'll give you the recipe afterwards. And mix it up, and then you take the matzah meal. Now, here's a problem. If you like matzah ball like I do, fluffy, you just put in 3/4 cup. But if you want a real hard matzo ball, you have to put in a little bit softer than cement. So and you start making the knedlach very nice and round. You have to be very careful. They should come out nice and beautiful so the people will like them. You see, if it doesn't come out so round, you see one thing is sticking out, give a knack, you know. You don't have to be afraid of it. It won't hit you back. And you just make it, you see, it's almost perfect. And I put it in the hot water. They don't have to be all the same size. The bigger ones you take for your family, so. And the smaller ones you can give the guests, what do they know? Because we are doing it a demonstration, I have it all done and all ready, so you'll see how the matzo ball come out. We have hot soup prepared for you, and you have it right here. And that is the ready product.